that is all misplaced. The vehemence that they have for achieving something and the tireless work till they achieve the goal, they are only following what Vivekananda has said. Don't worry, tirelessly you, that is, you take your efforts and endeavor for something and don't get back till you get that. They are into that, they are least bothered about anything to be lost. So they love sacrifices. So that is their greatness. So understanding the various members of the society, I have already told how the consciousness levels they have to be studied. By physical, number one, by clinical, number two, by their mental, number three, intellectual, two things are there. I have already told, properly placed, super placed and misplaced. Properly placed is a track of a normal life with perfection. Super is for contributing the global welfare. Misplaced is for self-destruction or a collective mass destruction or genocide or whatever it may be. So, as this being the introductory lecture for consciousness, let us have a proper time. Wherein by, you must also develop a lot of questions inside you, and instead of just me saying something from the fundamentals, from the rudimentary schools of consciousness, dealing with a lot of abstract and dry philosophy concepts which have no color, glamour and valor, just as you have in history and other subjects like mass communication, then media entertainment. There are a lot of very enjoyable classes where we want to conduct the classes even in night times. So this thing is not like that. So first, what I want to say is, whatever I have told today, it has been recorded. Just go through it twice or thrice. It has clearly defined you consciousness, the definitions of consciousness, multiple reflections of consciousness, and how to make ourselves to be a good receptacle of to the level of consciousness which we deserve or desire as per our mission of life. This I have concluded today and hope to see you again with individualized, personalized, customized mission and project-oriented advices and channelizations for you, as we cannot generally give all things for all people. Depending upon your skill, being analytical in maths, etc., or athletical, artistic in nature or atheistic in nature, aesthetic in nature, whatever it may be, whether it is theistic towards God or it is towards material or it is towards science or through arts, anything it may be, let it be your proper selection, wherein by the application of consciousness will surmount you in the paramount peak of never fading fame and also prosperity to all of those who are connected with you. Narayan, Narayan.
The definition of knowledge and innocence in the context of consciousness.
Knowledge. See, you are knowing about this thing. You are knowing about this thing. To know. It starts with to know. It starts with apprehension. The basic instinct is apprehension. To know this is of different types. To know that it is a glass of water, to know that this water is H2O, to know that the water is in Sanskrit known as Toya or Pani in Hindi. There are several levels of understanding. Each and everything is informed, that is formed inside. Whatever that you get, that this is water, whenever you see a similar structure, you will get it connected with the term water, or whenever you say the term water, you will get flashed the formation of a similar structure like this. So these things are known as informations. These informations, that they are scattered. For example, if you are moving here, you are seeing different entities. For example, this is a carpet, and that is a threshold, and that is a staircase, and that is a road, that is a car. Are they connected? Everything is connected with you formally? Huh? Are they connected with you with any order? They are having only one order, known as function. If you want to go from this place to your house, you have to unavoidably step on this carpet, cross this threshold, get down the stairs, take up an auto, you have to go there. Otherwise, auto, carpet, other things, naturally, do they have any formal connection or orderly placement? They don't have. So these type of informations, even though they are different, they are known as collectible or collective informations. They are not known as collectible and collective informations. Whereas If you want to read about water, you are studying about the types of water like the rain water, storage water, underground water, that H2O, how electrolysis of water is done, all of these things, whether they are orderly placed or not. Say yes or no.
Yes.
So when you move a lot of things functionally, even though they are connected with your function, phenomenally they are not united, they are not collectible or collecting. Unless you yourself have some other very whimsical and quixotic desire to collect it. So whenever you say about a thing and read everything about that, for example, if it is a digital recorder about sound, sound recording, sound reproduction, then analog recording, digital recording, everything that has an order or not. So the collective, collectible, orderly information put together on a different platform, an exclusive platform for a same specific objective known as knowledge. So knowledge is defined as the collectible, collective information that are being put on a specific platform for a same specific object. Repeat it.
Yeah.
No, repeat it in Hindi or something. I want to know how much you understood.
The knowledge which is collected.
You just tell it as a story. Let it be even depictive.
The knowledge is defined as per what you have said now, is a collected information which can be collected on a particular platform.
Orderly collection. What is orderly collection? If it is water,
yeah,
then what is the chemical structure of water? What is the physical property of water? How water is produced? What are all the forces of water? How it can be applied? And water resource management, then rainwater harvesting. Starting from the ontological study of water, you can come up to rain harvesting system. And water scarcity and global water crisis of 2020. You can come to any level. Isn't it so? So, this orderly, ontological, analytical and systemic placement of essential, there are two definitions, essential and number two, it must be essential information. You must not think that, see, given information about water, my neighbor is having water inside the pot. Is it very essential? It must be essential. And second thing, it must be authenticated. You must not think trivial and useless, water is coming in the boy's nose like that. So, collectibility and collective presentation of essential and authentic informations on the same platform of a same and specific object or structure or element is known as knowledge. And knowledge has come from know, to know. What are the steps of knowledge? See, I am asking you to get down. Asking you to get up. What are the processes? You say that?
See, if I have to get up, then I have to see what I can do for getting up. That is.
That's what I am asking. What is that?
So I have to use.
It is a very wondrous
brain.
Answer. Yeah. What is that?
So I have to use my brain so that you know.
You did not use brain. Uses you.
Huh?
What are the physical?
Yeah.
Reflex, response, yes. Reply, and other things.
Yeah.
Huh?
So by order. Physical body that you know I should get and stand up.
First of all, you are giving ankle pressure. It is known as ankle pressure. Then ankle acceleration. Then you are doing liftment, a process of liftment. Then mass balancing. Then self-structure replacement or reinstallation of your physical gravity. Then you are making placements of walk and coming here.